Hello and welcome to 9design 3D. Today we will make this cute highheels modeling. Let's go to the tutorial. First, we will download some mannequin character from the mix demo. You can choose this under the character part and you can download it. After you download this FBX file, go to File, Import and FBX, choose your T-pose. Select all of it with your armature and bodies and Alt-P, clear and keep transform. Now, as you see, our mesh is separated. Now you can delete your armature from here because we will use this mannequin for making our heels. Go to wireframe mode and in tap to edit mode for the mesh, you can choose some part of your vertices from your character. And after that, when your proportional edit is selected, as you see from the top, you can G to move your character's feet and toes in the Z-axis. Cause we will fit up our character's foot for making our heels clearly. After you make it, we will add a plane for our scene and scale for fitting up your character's feet scale. With the numpad 7 is top view, control numpad 7 you can see your plane on the bottom. Add some loop cuts with Ctrl R, after that choose your some vertices and scale and move them for fitting and making a shape for your high heels bottom part. You can move your vertices with the choosing all of it or some part of your vertices. Give a shape for your heels first part. Add a new loop cut for the vertically, press S, X and 0 and tidy up it. Choose your outside vertices lines. Don't forget to choose your bottom and top vertices. E to extrude them in Z axis and E to extrude them again up. Now go again for the wireframe. With the numpad 3 you can see your mesh from the side view. In wireframe we will scale and place our vertices as the same method for fitting up our shoes or character foot. After you tidy up all of it, choose these two vertex and press F to fill. And you can right click and subdivide it. We will make same thing for the other side vertices. Choose two of vertices and press F. Continue to make same thing. And don't forget to subdivide it because we need this middle vertices. Choose four of vertex and press F to fill. And choose these two and F to fill again. We will make a good topology for our heels. Continue to make fill it. Again, F to fill for middle vertices. Choose this four vertex and F to fill. As you see, this topology came good. And in object mode, we will add a subdivision surface modifier to this. You can fit up some edges and vertices for the scale and G to move. You can change your shape of your high heels with the changing your vertex places. Now we will add a solidify modifier and move up to the subdivision surface. Solidify will be first modifier tool and set up your thickness with the even thickness. After that apply it. Now we will make this heel part. You can choose some faces from here. E to extrude, right click and E to extrude it down again. After that add extra loop cut. And in the wireframe, you can tidy up it again. Choose this top vertex line and scale. Our shoes main parts will be look like this. Now from the freesvg.com, I downloaded some butterfly vectors from here. We will use this SVG and we will convert this butterfly silhouette for the 3D mesh. You can hide all of it. Go to File, Import and choose SVG, Scalable Vector Graphic and after that choose your butterfly. It will look like that. This is not mesh now. We will convert it to the mesh. This is curve. You can join all of your parts. As you see, if you want, you can change your vertices and change your butterfly's shape. But I will not change. Go to curve settings. I will decrease my resolution from here. And I will give some extrude under the geometry. Now, right click, convert to mesh. It will look like this. You can choose some part of it with pressing L and after that press P, separation. For the wings, I will make same thing. I am pressing L and P, selection. Now they are separated. I am rotating my butterfly's wing and place it with the scaling behind the heels. And I will add some solidify modifier to this. You can right click shade smooth and don't forget to check your auto smooth. After that, I am adding a curve pad because I want to add extra line part for my high heels. You can scale it in tap to edit mode. You can move your control vertices and give around the shape for your pad curve. And after you fit it, from the curve settings, you can add an extrude in here with the less value. I added this type of extra detail for my high heels. And you can decrease your resolution and right click convert to mesh. And as the same method, I will use my butterfly again. And I will put it front of my shoes. You can place it. Most of butterfly or wings is your high heels. How you want, you can model it. I'm not making any extra thing in here as the same method. As you see, I am adding solidify modifier in it too. Now, under the edit, preferences, add-ons and type extra. Activate this extra objects because we will use some diamond shapes. With the shift A under the mesh, as you see, there is a diamond section in here. I will choose some brilliant diamond and you can scale and place middle of your butterfly. I will shift it to duplicate it and adding extra diamonds for my shoes. Where you want, you can put it or you can use some gem, different type of. Where you want, you can put shift it to duplicate, rotate and scale, adding your shoes. I added my extra details like that. Now let's add some materials. I am adding a shoe main material from here and I will choose a pink. From here you can increase your metallic and decrease your roughness. For the inner part, with the plus icon you can add second material for this and choose some faces of your shoes and after that assign your second material. When you want, you can change your material's color. For the butterfly, I will add some greenish material later. I am changing my metallic and roughness values for giving a bit shiny metallic look. For the heels part, I am adding new material in here with the shiny metallic as a greenish. With the Ctrl plus, you can select your extra faces. For the bottom part of my shoes, I am adding my third material to here. And you can assign it. My shoes will be look like this. For the diamonds, I am adding a diamond material. You can increase your transmission 1 and decrease your roughness and specular. You can change your base color of your diamonds, of course. And again, I am changing my butterfly's color. If you want, you can add extra materials with the choosing your butterfly faces. Our shoes will be look like that. Where you want, you can use this. Maybe for your vroid characters or anime characters, how you want. You can use this method for making easy high heels shoes for your characters. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you later in new tutorials. If you want, you can support me with the thanks button. See you later.